So, okay. Okay. So, for WordPress 4.4 will be released in on 8th of December. So, there are a lot of changes, about over 2,000 commits, individual commits in the entire repository. But these are the few that are highlighted. So, first, it's embedding content. Second is responsive image. Third is title tag support. Fourth is the term meta. The fifth is comments. They did a full review on that. So I'll just go through, if you don't understand, I'll just go through it in brief later. So for the embedding of your content, is basically embedding your own content on other websites. If you see content like you see content like from sites like Twitter, they allow you to embed content in on other sites, right? So basically what WordPress does is that instead of consuming this kind of content, they extended their code base to provide this content to other people as well. So it follows the old embed standards, which YouTube, sites like YouTube, Twitter, they follow. Facebook doesn't follow it, they have their own standard. These standards, right, makes use of REST API, makes use of JavaScript. If your user has JavaScript block, there's a block code fallback. And not only that, you also can customize the output. So a quick example that can be found is that it's something like this. So as you can see, it's very plain. This is the default. It's very plain. You can just embed it in, and whatever that can be changed, you can change in the using the head or the embed head and embed footer action hooks. Yeah. So you can also share. You see the share icon in circle, and then you can share using HTML. And then if your site is also a WordPress site, right, you basically just need to share the link. Just put a link into your own WordPress site. You see a WordPress site, let's say you see a Tech Asia site, if they move on to 4.4, you just copy a link into your own site, they will just update as well. The second one is responsive image insertion. So what happened in the past is that responsive image is not, the support is not really there for, natively. You have to do a lot of your own hacking about to enable the responsive image. So in 4.4, the text now contains source set and sizes. So using source set and sizes, right, these are actually are the new stuff that enables responsive image natively. And they actually backport it to be version 4.0 through using the plugin system. So you can go to this plugin page. So let's a bit small. Can go to this plugin page, and then basically they came up with the plugin to do the same thing as well. So it's I've yet to test it out lah, but it's actually quite good. And then natively, for native example wise, right, you can look at their 2016 theme. So 2016 is their new theme for WordPress 4.4. It's for the next year, the whole of next year. It's actually an example theme for automatic to showcase the full capabilities of this WordPress version. So if you can you can see from the codes over here that they make use of the new filters to insert the images for responsiveness. That is the responsive image insertion. The next one is title tag support. So they actually they're moving to replace WP title. So in the currently what team developers do is to put this WP team title function into the WordPress theme file, and then you have to and then you will come out with the title. However, right now they added in this hook called add theme support title tag. So what you can do is that you can just change your title in your theme in the appearance menu, and then you just change accordingly. Initially they want to deprecate WP title but they backtrack on that because it's rather sudden. So it's expected that they will remove it in the next version, if not then the next few major versions. But all these are still in discussion. If you're interested in the development, you can actually look at their Slack channel or their repository. So native function wise is very simple. Okay, so native sample is just basically this one line here. So as you can see in the comments, let WordPress manage the document title. So so it declare that it does not need to use hard-coded title tag. You will just use fallback onto the WP head function. Okay, term meta. Term meta is actually targeted towards categories and tags. So in the past, category and tags, right, you just only can have the slug and then the name. Whereas now that you can add in additional metas to it. Let's say you want to explain what is the text about in detail instead of just the normal description. Let's say you have a country, you want to explain that, you want to put a flag there. You can use this term meta to put these new functions to put in the flag. When they build this, they actually build it with performance in mind, and they actually will query the meta on the first load, and subsequent load is just loaded from a cache. I won't go into the details on the implementation because it's very technical. Can actually look later I share the link. The last part is comments revamp. So what they did was to rebuild our WP comments class. So for like WP posts, they actually in the previous versions they optimized on WP posts and almost everything else except for WP comments. So WP comments was actually wasn't very performant. So they rebuilt the WP comment class. They came up with a new WP comment query functions as well. And the one of the most visible change for the themes is that this is the old one. This is the current format. Whereas the new format is basically the comments first. So it's actually highly encouraged. If you have made any modifications to your to your comments, your native comments, look, it's highly encouraged that you do a testing on the beta versions of 4.4. So there are also other details like multi-site momentum. So they are rebuilding multi-site to make it more performant, make it load faster. Personally, I don't use multi-site, so because of the performance issues. But if it works out right, why not? And we can use it for a lot of things. The next one is headings in admin panels. They are making it more more coherent. That is more on the backend stuff. And then of course 2016 is coming out together with 4.4. So all these actually can be found in the field guide. So WordPress 4.4 field guide. It contains it's a brief guide on for the teams, for any developers, any users actually, to have a preview on what to be expected for 4.4 without diving deep into, without you installing, having to install the WordPress 4.4 and test out on your own. Yeah, so this is from WordPress.org itself. Yeah, so that's all about 4.4. Yeah. Okay. I move on to the next one first. So we do give out a feedback survey for the meetup starting last meetup. So I'm going to give the link out later again through the Facebook group events and the meetup event itself. So these are some of the topics that some of the audience actually raised. So the first one is actually to I just copy and paste this, so it's actually in verbatim. So it's like topics and subjects on how to put ads on WordPress. The second one is best practices and pitfalls on coding, and the last one is useful plugins. Because I also want to keep this time short, so I just only cover the first one. I'll reserve the next two topics for another time. So it's actually very brief. It's just this one slide. to put ads on on WordPress, it used to be very painful. You have to hard code directly in the child team. So you have to come up with your child team, and then you go inside and copy the codes in directly and stuff. But now there's this plugin called AdRotate. So AdRotate allows custom advertisements. So let's say you have your own source of advertisements. Let's say your friends want to advertise on your site, and then you want to at least give them some statistics, some scheduling, some rotation and stuff like that. You can do that. If you do not have any custom ads, you can enable external ad services. So you can put in ads from AdWords, from Unity, or from Criteo. All these are ad servers. How you put in is through using a widget or shortcode or in the template itself. You can, like I mentioned, you can schedule, you can do scheduling, you can do rotation, and it offers some statistics. So let me show you the WordPress directory. So you actually can find it over here, AdRotate. So it's very comprehensive. And if you want to have, these are all the features. Certain features are exclusive to AdRotate Pro, like geo-targeting. So if you do not need to geo-target, if your ads is very general, you don't need to worry. But if your ads require you to geo-target to, let's say, one or two countries, let's say it's only in China, or target to China or to Taiwan or to Hong Kong, then maybe you can consider getting the Pro version. And I actually encountered it on this site that I was helping you do. Oh no, why is it on channel settings? Give me a moment. Yeah, okay. So this is an example where you can actually, just to show you, this is a demo advertisement, so nothing sensitive on here. You can actually see that it's a demo ad. By right, you're supposed to have like preview, but it's broken. Then banner assets, and then you can put a banner asset, or you can put in a banner folder to do a rotation, and then you can activate it, you can or show not to activate it and stuff like that. Then it gives you the instructions as well on dragging the widgets. Basically, it's very clear cut. Like you want to put in widget, or you want to use a shortcode, or directly a theme, so like the usual PHP echo, and you can schedule it to start when and end when. Yeah, there are also other advanced stuff like responsiveness, sort, all these are for Pro, the Pro version. Yep, so that's about it for my side. Yep, so for December, yeah, so the December meetup is already planned. Will be on the 16th of December, so exactly 1 month from now. The first topic is already confirmed, because he already said that he'll share when he's back. So he'll be there for a week. The camp is about 3 days, 3 days long. The work camp is about 3 days long. He'll be back in time to share with us. Yeah, so if you all have any other topics that you all want to hear about, please fill in the feedback form, and then we'll try to find speakers. If you all have anything to speak about as well, like if you have something to share, like you have come up with some fantastic theme or some fantastic plugins you want to share, go ahead. We are very open to just to let you all have your 5 minutes of fame. Yeah. So yeah, that's all for me. Yeah. And we